Hello friends, today we are going to learn about the block diagram representation. So block diagram is nothing but a shorthand pictorial representation of a system between a input and output. So the purpose of block diagram is to find a transfer function of a overall system. Suppose if we have one system in which we have number of components involved and we want to analyze the output of a system when we provide some specific input. So it is much easier to represent a system in the form of block diagrams connected in a systematic manner so that when we apply an input to that particular block diagram, we get some specific output. And that output we can find by making use of what a transfer function. So in the previous sessions, we have learned about the definitions of a transfer function and how do we calculate a transfer function. So basically, we have learned about two fundamental definitions. So next, suppose if we have one system over here, right now you can see we have one circuit over here, and in that particular circuit, suppose if we provide some input, so that particular input actuates the component in this particular system, and that causes to generate a specific output. And if I want to represent that particular system in the form of block, then I can simply represent in this particular manner. So block diagram is just a shorthand pictorial representation of a system. So now you can see the input I can represent with the help of symbol RS, where S represents a Laplace domain, and similarly the output we represent with the help of CS. Okay, so now you can see we have represented this particular system with the help of GS over here, and we have applied input and we have found the output. So the GS is nothing but a transfer function of this particular system. So now, as we have already seen, that the system is of two types. First one is an open loop form and next one is a closed loop form. So we have already discussed in detail about these two things. So now I directly take a mathematical representation. So now you can see in an open loop form, we have a direct input applied to a system and we get an output. So to represent a system, we can find a transfer function by considering the Laplace transform of output to a Laplace transform of an input. So you can see in open loop transfer function, we do not have any component of output involved in the input. So I can directly write a transfer function for this particular system. Similarly, if we consider a closed loop system, so now we know in a closed loop system, we have number of things involved over here and we have a component of output available at an input segment. Okay, and that particular signal, which is called as error signal, we also called as actuating signal, which actuates the controller involved in a closed loop system. So you can get a more detailed discussion on a closed loop transfer function video, which I have already uploaded. So now you can see the components over here is what GS, HS. So GS is nothing but a forward path gain, as when we applied an input, we get an output. Okay, so GS is nothing but a forward path gain. Okay, and it is over here is a ratio of CS by ES. Apart from that, over here we have a HS. HS is nothing but a feedback path gain. And now you can see over here we have a output CS, which is acting as an input for this particular feedback segment. And we get the output BS over here. So we know for a representation of a transfer function, we can write a output Laplace transform divided by Laplace transform of input. So we have over here what? A BS divided by CS. So now one more term over here is a open loop gain. So I guess you remember that in the previous segment, we have learned that when we apply input, we have one more block over here, which is called as what? A controller. Then we have a process over here and we have got a output. And again, we have one a feedback network in which the present output is provided as a input. So now you can see we have got a this type of system. And I have already told you this particular thing over here is nothing but an error signal. This error signal is also called as actuating system signal because it actuates a controller. So now you can see in a closed loop control system, we have a actuating signal, and that particular actuating signal controls the controller available in a closed loop control system. Okay, and that modifies the process which provide a specific output required at that particular segment of time. So now you can see for that particular actuating signal, we have got a GS and HS, which are now acting as a signals in series, and that applied summing point. So now you can see we have a output over here. Okay, if we consider a actuating signal, so now you can see we have a multiplication of GS and HS, which is applied to this point. Okay, and we get a output. So this GS and HS is now acting as a open loop gain over. So this is a very much important. So when we talk about a closed loop control system, we have GS, HS, which is called as open loop transfer function of a non-unity feedback system. Non-unity feedback system means when the component of HS is defined in a system. If the HS value is equals to 1, then we can consider it as a unity feedback system. But since if we have some expression over here, then we can consider it as a non-unity feedback system. So now in the next point, you can also see if HS is equals to 1, then GS is representing what? Open loop transfer function of a unity feedback system, because the component of HS is 1 over here. So GS is nothing but a OLTF of a unity feedback system. So now if we want to define an expression for this particular type of system, so you can see we can easily derive the expression. Let us suppose first I am writing an equation for ES over here. Okay, so ES is nothing but a RS plus minus BS. Apart from that, CS I can write as a GS multiplication of ES. Okay, CS is output, and when we applied a error signal ES in this particular GS, we get a CS. So I have simply written over here that particular thing only. And again, the BS is nothing but a HS multiplication of CS, because BS is acting as an output, and over here we have applied a CS as an input in this particular HS network. Okay, so now we have these three fundamental equations. Okay, and based on that, we find a ratio CS by RS. So now I can write ES as what? CS divided by GS, and similarly, I can substitute the value of BS from this equation, which is nothing but a HS multiply CS. Okay, so when I multiply GS over here and shifting a CS over here, we get the value CS is nothing but a GS RS plus minus HS GS RS. And from that, I can write CS by RS as GS divided by 1 plus minus GS HS. Okay, so now you can see we have over here what the transfer function for this particular system as GS divided by 1 minus plus, I have written over here wrongly, 1 minus plus GS RS. Okay, because this thing when I move over here, so the sign would get changed from minus, from plus minus to minus plus. Okay, that's why it is over here minus plus. So we have CS by RS, which is nothing but a GS divided by 1 minus plus GS HS. So this is a closed loop transfer function. Okay, so this is the expression for CLTF. One more expression I want to discuss with you corresponding to a unity feedback system. Okay, suppose if we have a unity feedback system, then in that particular instant, we have a value of GS, which is equal, we have a value of HS, which is equals to 1. Okay, so for a unity feedback system, when HS is equals to 1, we have CS by RS, which is called a CLTF. Okay, so I write simply closed loop transfer function over here. And now over here, since GS is equals to 1, so we have HS is equals to 1, we have GS 1 minus plus GS. Okay, so GS is called as what? Open loop transfer function. So this is one of the very important expression which you require to solve a numerical. Okay, so closed loop transfer function for a unity feedback system is equal to what? A open is equal to a ratio of open loop transfer function divided by 1 minus plus open loop transfer function.